Hello guys, welcome back to WeTrends. I'm Anusha.
And this is Shrihasha. And we are here today with a new and exciting video. And this video is going to be very helpful for all the freshers joining VIT this year.
We know being a fresher, a lot of questions must have come to your mind. We are here to help you figure out a few queries in this part 2 video. If you guys haven't watched the part 1 video, make sure you watch it. The link to which will be given in the description below. Now let's get directly into the video.
Hey Anusha, what do you think? Which query should we answer first?
I guess the orientation would be the better to answer first.
Okay then, let's get right into the academic orientation one.
Basically, the academic orientation is for introducing you guys to VIT, your academic curriculum and your HOD and D. They will let you know all the things you will study during your 4 years and all other opportunities. First, we will start with some of the most basic things you need to know about VIT as soon as you join. When you take admission in VIT, the first thing you would be provided is a proctor, an email ID and your VTOP login credentials.
Now, I'll explain you about the proctor system. A proctor is someone who acts as your mentor in college, and if you have any problem, you first go to him before contacting any other higher authority. And he or she would get your academic records as well and hold a proctor meeting from time to time for answering any of your queries. And the email ID. You will be given an official student email ID by the college where you will get all the mails regarding the activities, events, circular, etc. Now let's get to our very old website VTOP. VTOP is a site where you can see all your information. From your profile details, timetable, assignment, fee submission, everything.
Now VIT also has an app called the VITN app, which is basically the same as VTOP but in the form of an app. So it's easier for you to access it from your mobile phone. Now you also have to open a bank account in one of the banks in the campus. That is where all the money transfers would take place. For example, if VIT has to refund any money, they would put it in your bank account.
Now let's move on to hostel and bed options. Students have to stay in campus hostel only. There is no option to take up room or PG outside the campus. First of all, the hostels are allocated according to your CGPA. To know more about this process, make sure you check out our video about async and hostel counseling process, the link to which will be provided in the description. The types of beds, rooms available are different for different years. And for the first year students, get only shared rooms. Sharing room between 3 or 4 or 6 students. In men's hostel, there are 18 blocks in total, but for freshers, there are mainly 3 blocks, M, N and P blocks. They are either fully AC'd or non-AC blocks. About the hostel room, you will get 5 types of room: single bed, double bed, triple bed, 4 bed or 6 bed.
For the girls, there are 6 blocks in total. The girls' hostel has 2 variants, apartment type and non-apartment type. The apartment type has 2 room categories, 3 and 4 beds, while non-apartment type rooms have 3 categories, 3, 4 and 6 beds. For the fee details of the hostel, you can refer to the VIT official site, and we have also put a screenshot of the hostel details here as well.
Let's get some basic rules that you need to know about the hostels here. In terms. The in time for girls at the main gate is around 7 PM and at the hostel gate is around 8 PM. For the boys, the in time at the main gate is about 8:30 PM and the hostel gate is 9:30 PM. And there are strict wardens who will take care of your attendance. And if you need to stay out of hostel after in time, you need to have an approved pass which says you have some club or chapter work to do. And parents are allowed in the hostel area but not allowed inside the hostel building. Heavy electric devices like kettle, iron, hairdryer are not at all allowed.
Now we are talking about the hostels, how can we not tell you about the mess? There are types of mess available in VIT, veg, non-veg and special mess. You can choose any mess according to your preferences and cost, but you can't eat from the mess other than the one you opted for. You're allowed to order food from outside as well using Swiggy, but it will be delivered at the main gate and you have to go there and collect it.
Now I'll tell you something about outings and leaves. On weekdays, students are allowed 4 hours of outing in a day and the time starts as soon as you leave the campus gates. And in the weekend, students can leave up to 6 hours, but you have to get a leave request signed by the warden and the message will go directly to your parents, so be careful.
Now there are four types of leaves. The first is the general leave. You can apply a leave to go to your hometown or your local guardian's place. You can do this maximum twice in a month. Second one is with parents' leave. You can leave any number of times if your parent comes to pick you up in person. You have all normal winter and summer vacation, which is actually the third kind of leave. And the last is the special leave for instances that do not fall in the above mentioned categories.
I've seen many queries about laptops, and I would like to give my suggestion. See, laptops are the most important thing that every engineering student needs, but they are very confused about the specification, which laptop will be helpful throughout the engineering. And if you are budget friendly and searching for a good laptop, then my suggestion, you should take a laptop of minimum i5 10th gen with both HDD and HDD and with a minimum up to 8GB RAM. If you can go up to 90,000, then Mac would be better. In start, you may get some trouble finding software, but you will get used to it because of your help of your seniors and faculty.
Now let me tell you something about sports and gym in VIT. So in VIT hostels, you will get both paid and free gyms nest freak people. The fee of paid gyms is around 6,000 per semester, depending upon the gym type, with all the good equipments. Even the free gyms are good, but have some less essentials compared to the paid one. Yes, and about the sports, there are a few badminton courts around the hostel blocks and even basketball courts. Also, the sport grounds are big to practice your athletic games and football. VIT has a sports team too, and selection to them is based on your sports performance in competition.
Let me tell something about Fest Rivera. Rivera is a cultural fest of VIT, which is one of the best college fests in India. It is usually somewhere around February of every year, and it is a 4-day fest in which there are multiple fun-packed events organized by various clubs and chapters, which the students can enjoy with their friends. There are famous food outlets, swings, etc., and bunch load of proms. Famous personalities or celebrities like singers, dancers, actors, comedians can be seen performing the pro shows, where the student can get a chance to have a concert-like experience in the college. Overall, it's a complete load of full fun package for which every VITian is excited every year.
There are also endless clubs and chapters to choose from in VIT based on your interest. There will be a whole presentation for you. Every club and chapter will tell you about themselves and encourage you to join them. Usually, there is a whole entry process for joining a club or a chapter where the club members either take a test or you based on the domains.
Let me tell you about SAP and ITP programs. See, students can get an opportunity to go abroad internships. What's more is you can transfer those credits too. If courses are certified, then you can include those courses and credit them for a minimum credit required. And let me tell you about SAP. SAP is nothing but Semester Abroad Program. This is an international program set by International Office of VIT, wherein you can do the last semester abroad in the partnering universities of VIT.
Under International Transfer Program, you can do 2 years in VIT, and for the next 2 years, you can get transferred to one of the foreign universities. This is offered only to engineering streams. For more information on this, you can visit International Relations on VIT's official website. Link will be given in the description.
I don't see any queries, so now it's time to say bye to you all. And we hope this video was very informative to all of you. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more videos telling you more about VIT. And we have a lot of interesting content planned for future. So click on the bell icon there if you would like to be notified about them.
Also, don't forget to follow our Instagram and Facebook pages, where you can ask any of your further doubts and we would be sure to clear them all.
Thank you for joining us. Now we will be taking your leave.